Hello friends, welcome to Aasaan IAS. Hope you are enjoying the program Transform into an IAS Officer in 100 Days. Friends, if you can believe, you may start, but if you can understand, you will achieve. If you talk of Indian geography, we have physiography, drainage system, soils and agriculture, climate and natural vegetation, resources. Two questions from physiography, one from drainage system, one from soils and agriculture, one from climate and natural vegetation, one from resources. Total 6 questions from geography, Indian geography I am expecting. So physiography and drainage system are very, very important. So the first question can be expected on physical features. It can be asked on geographical facts or islands, northern plains and desert, or on political map. So first we understand important geographical facts. You need to understand very basic facts like the area is 3.28 million square kilometers, which is 2.4% of the geographical area of the world. India is the 7th largest country in terms of size and 2nd population wise. So the westernmost state is Gujarat and the easternmost state is Arunachal Pradesh. Similarly, no need to mug up exactly. So the distance from westernmost point to easternmost point is 2933 kilometers, approximately 3000 kilometers. And westernmost longitude is 68 degrees 7 minutes and easternmost is 97 degrees 25 minutes. The northernmost state is Jammu and Kashmir. The southernmost state is Tamil Nadu. And the northernmost point and southernmost point, 3214 kilometers. Hope you know these basics. 37 degrees 6 minutes is the northernmost latitude and southernmost latitude is 8 degrees 4 minutes. Of course, I am talking about the mainland. If you talk about even we have Andaman and Nicobar also. So the southernmost point is Indira Point, which is in Great Nicobar Island. Mainland where southernmost is in Tamil Nadu, otherwise southernmost is Indira Point. So Indian Standard Time. So you know the westernmost longitude is 68 approximately and easternmost is 97. So the average of these two is 82.5 degrees east. So which is what is Indian standard time. If you see, it passes through Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. So IST passes through 5 states, UP, MP, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and AP. If you see the Tropic of Cancer, which passes through 8 states, Gujarat, राजस्थान थोड़ा से राजस्थान से भी जा रहा है मध्य प्रदेश छत्तीसगढ़ झारखंड वेस्ट बंगाल त्रिपुरा एंड मिजोरम सो ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर पासेस थ्रू 8 स्टेट्स फ्रॉम वेस्ट टू ईस्ट यू रिमेंबर गुजरात राजस्थान मध्य प्रदेश छत्तीसगढ़ झारखंड वेस्ट बंगाल त्रिपुरा एंड मिजोरम. Don't mug up, please keep this picture in mind. Pata nahi na questions kaisa puchega isle. So the total length of coastline including islands is approximately 7500 kilometers and the mainland coastline is 6100 kilometers. The coastal states are, 9 states are coastal states. Gujarat, that is what we call Kathiawar coast. Maharashtra and Goa, so Maharashtra and Goa, that is Konkan coast. Karnataka, that is what we call Kendra coast. Kerala, we call Malabar coast. Tamil Nadu, on the eastern side. Andhra Pradesh, so this is what we call Coromandel coast. Then Northern AP, we call Northern Sarkars. Odisha, we call Utkal coast. And West Bengal. Hope you understand these 9 coastal states. So the state in India with the largest coastline is Gujarat. Suppose if you ask the largest coastline on the eastern side, that is Andhra Pradesh, or Andhra Pradesh is the second largest coastline. Goa is the state with smallest coastline. If you see the gulfs, Gulf of Kutch, so which is renowned for extreme tides. Similarly, this is Gulf of Cumber or Gulf of Cambay. This is Gulf of Mannar. This is Park Strait. This is Kori Creek here. Similarly, this is Sir Creek. This is what is the border between India and Pakistan. So there was a dispute also that we claim that the entire Sir Creek is in India, they claim that entire Sir Creek is in Pakistan. So broadly a mind me rakhe position. What is strait? Strait is a water body that separates two land masses. What is creek? Creek is a natural stream of water, normally of very small width, just like a canal. Now, Zero Milestone. It is a monument locating the geographical center of colonial India in the city of Nagpur. Just choti exams mein puchega, Zero Milestone is located where? It is located in Nagpur. So, in British India, it was used to measure the distances because Nagpur is literally the center of colonial India. Now, if you see the border states, India has 15,000 plus kilometer of land border. Like 7500 kilometer of coastline including islands, 61 kilometer excluding islands, that means mainland. Similarly, 15106 kilometer land border it shares. It shares border with Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Myanmar. Don't mug up, please understand from the picture. Literally aapko map yaad hona chahiye. Four Indian states share border with Pakistan. You know, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab and Jammu Kashmir. See, Himachal Pradesh or Haryana does not share border with Pakistan. India and Pakistan border line is 3323 kilometer. No need to mug up. Only one Indian state share border with Afghanistan, that is Jammu and Kashmir. And the borderline is 106 kilometer because we claim the entire J&K. Of course, the present situation is different, but hope you are understanding. It is the shortest, just longest and shortest. Longest borderline we share with Bangladesh and shortest we share with Afghanistan. Five Indian states share border with China, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. Hope you understand. The border line is 3488 kilometer. It is the second largest after Bangladesh. With Nepal, five Indian states share border. Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal and Sikkim. Border line is 1751 kilometers. Ye figures aaj bhi yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi. Five Indian states share border with Bangladesh, West Bengal, Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. The border line is 4096 kilometer. It is the largest. Say point mind me rakhe, India share the largest border line with Bangladesh, then with China. Four Indian states share border with Bhutan, Sikkim, West Bengal, Assam, Arunachal. Please note, West Bengal also share. Hope you know the map. The border line is 699 kilometer. Four Indian states share border with Myanmar. Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur and Mizoram. The border line is 1643 kilometers. Take a question asked in 2015. Which one of the following pairs of states of India indicates the easternmost and westernmost state? Easternmost is Arunachal and westernmost is Gujarat. Very direct question, basic question. So the answer is Arunachal Pradesh and Gujarat. In India, how many states share the coastline? You can count also if you do not remember, if you can imagine the map. So if you see on the west side, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala, five states. Similarly, from south to north, on the eastern side, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal. So total nine states. See the answer. The Park Bay lies between. So Gulf of Kutch and Gulf of Cambat, Gulf of Mannar and Bay of Bengal. So Park Bay is between Gulf of Mannar and Bay of Bengal. It's not Lakshadweep. You see the options, how far they are. Hope you are understanding. Consider the following statements. Assam shares a border with Bhutan and Bangladesh. Just imagine, Assam shares border with each of the other six northeastern states. It shares border with Bhutan and it shares even border with Bangladesh. So first is correct. West Bengal shares a border with Bhutan and Nepal. Yes, West Bengal shares border with Bhutan, Nepal, Bangladesh. Mizoram shares a border with Bangladesh and Myanmar. Yes, Mizoram shares border with Bangladesh and Myanmar. I am imagining the map and telling you. Hope you are also doing the same. So all are correct. Which of the following states has the largest coastal line in India? So Gujarat has the largest coastline, but in the options it is not given. After that, Andhra Pradesh is largest. See, no need to remember the entire order. Just remember the top two. Gujarat on the whole and on the east side, Puducherry, yeah, second largest is Andhra Pradesh. In which of the following cities one can never see the sunshine overhead at noon? You see, sun always will be perpendicular or above the overhead between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So Visakhapatnam, Trivandrum and Bangalore are below Tropic of Cancer, you can understand. So Delhi to the north of Tropic of Cancer. So the sun can never be overhead at noon in Delhi. So A is the answer. Suppose if the question is not from geographical facts, it could be on islands. You know, these Andaman Nicobar Islands are considered as the continuation of Arkanyoma mountain ranges of Myanmar. There are 572 islands. Indira Point is the southernmost point of Indian Territory, 6.78 degree north, which is located in Great Nicobar. Hope you are understanding this one. Capital of Andaman Nicobar Islands is Port Blair, which is in South Andaman. This is South Andaman. This is Middle Andaman, North Andaman. Together, this is called Great Andaman. This archipelago is called Great Andaman. Middle Andaman is the largest in terms of area. Not only in Andaman Nicobar, even if you include Lakshadweeps. Lakshadweeps are very small, small islands. So overall, largest island of India is Middle Andaman. You have 10 degree channel here, which separates Andaman group and Nicobar group. Broadly, deep mein jayenge to, it separates Little Andaman to the north and Kar Nicobar to the south. 10 degree channel. Broadly speaking, Andaman group and Nicobar group. Duncan Passage is here, which separates Little Andaman to the south and South Andaman to the north, or you can say Great Andaman to the north. Overall baat karenge to. Duncan Passage separates Great Andaman to the north and Little Andaman to the south. Saddle Peak, which is 737 meter, it is the highest peak of Andaman and Nicobar and is located in North Andaman. So here is Saddle Peak, it is the highest peak which is in North Andaman. Barren Island, here is Barren Island, you find here active volcano. So Barren Island of Andaman group is the only active volcano of India. Even Narkondam may be volcano high, but it is not active now. If you talk about Lakshadweep, there are group of 36 small islands. These are very small compared to Andaman group. Capital is Kavarattu. So this is the capital. Most of the islands are atolls. Atolls are type of coral reefs, fringing reefs, barrier reefs, atolls, all are types of coral reefs. Largest island is Androt. Androt is the largest of Lakshadweeps. Second largest is Minicoy. And even Minicoy is the southernmost of this group. Southernmost island is Minicoy. If you see, the islands north of 11 degree north are known as Amindivi Islands, while that south to 9 degree north is Minicoy, and the ones which are in between are called Lakkadives. That's why iska naam hai pehle Lakkadiv, Amindivi and Minicoy. Baad mein change karke abhi Lakshadweeps banaya hai. So Lakshadweep group separated from Maldives by 8 degree channel. So Minicoy, this is 9 degree channel. This is 9 degree channel. This is, I am not drawing straight, please understand. This is 11 degree, 9 degree, and Minicoy ke niche jo hai ye 8 degree. And uske niche kya hai 8 degree ke baad Maldives hai. Now we will see some other important islands. New Moor Island, roughly position mind mein rakhe. So it is located in Bay of Bengal on the mouth of Ganga. It was disputed between India and Bangladesh. We both claim. But now it is submerged. We have Wheeler Island. Now it is known as Abdul Kalam Island. It is in Odisha, used for missile testing. If you must have seen many news mein dekha hoga, this missile, Agni 5, even you have BrahMos, these are being successfully test fired from Abdul Kalam Island. Aisa karke likha hota hai. We have Sriharikota. It is in Andhra Pradesh, Pulikat Lake and Bay of Bengal ke beech mein. So it is a rocket launching site, you know. Our satellites are launched from here. We have Pamban Island. Pamban Island is located in between Gulf of Mannar. You know, this is Gulf of Mannar. It Tamil Nadu mein hai. Pamban Island. Even Rameshwaram, the place is, the city is on this island. Pamban Island. And we have Wellington Island here. Kochi port was built on this island. It is formed between Arabian Sea and that Vembanad Lake. Now we will talk about important beaches. Roughly mind me rakhe, very rarely questions come. Gopnath Beach is very popular beach in Gujarat. Similarly, we have Tital Beach in Gujarat. So Gopnath and Tital are important beaches of Gujarat. We have Manori. Juhu, Juhu is in Mumbai. And Ganapati Phule. These are important beaches of Maharashtra. Similarly, we have Baga, Palolem, Sinkaram. These beaches are in Goa. Sinkaram beach is very famous. Goa mein. Devbag beach, Karnataka. Gokarna beach, Karnataka. Malpe beach, Karnataka. These are also important beaches of Karnataka. We have Snehatirtham, Kochi, jo Kerala ka beach, Kerala mein. Even Bangaram Beach, Lakshadweep mein, Bangaram Island is there. Bangaram Beach is very popular. On the eastern side, we have Radhanagar, also known as Havelock Beach, Andaman Nicobar mein. Promenade, Puducherry mein. We have Golden Beach, Marina Beach in Chennai. Marina Beach, you know, it is the longest natural sand urban beach. Jo city ke andar naturally sand se bana hua bahut lamba beach hai, 13 kilometer length, Marina Beach. Machilipatnam, important fort also, jab Europeans mein pada hai humne, Andhra Pradesh mein hai. Similarly, Kakinada is in Andhra Pradesh, RK Beach, Rishikonda Beach, Larsen's Bay Beach, these are all in Visakhapatnam. Bhimunipatnam is also in Andhra Pradesh. Bhimunipatnam, or you can call Bhimilipatnam, one and the same. Gopalpur on Sea, Odisha mein hai. Similarly, Gahir Mata, you know, Bitarganika mangroves, uska beach hai Gahir Mata, known for olive ridley turtles. It is in Odisha. Similarly, Chandipur, Odisha mein hai, very popular and unique because every day, you know, the water will go 2-3 kilometer inside. Literally, you can walk on that sand, again water come after some time. So, Chandipur. We have Sagar Beach in West Bengal, Ganga Sagar Mela. So, these are some important beaches in India. Take a question asked in 2014. Which one of the following pairs of islands is separated from each other by the 10 degree channel? So broadly puch raha hai, 10 degree channel separates Andaman group and Nicobar group. Even not exactly asking kaun si hai. Aisa puchega to abhi little Andaman kar Nicobar answers mein hoga. So Nicobar and Sumatra, Maldives and Lakshadweeps, Sumatra and Java. You see, bilkul broad question hai, yehi the answer. Duncan Passage is located between. It is located Great Andaman, upper and niche Little Andaman. So option A, North Andaman and South Andaman, North Andaman and Kar Nicobar, South Andaman and Kar Nicobar, South Andaman and Little Andaman. So the best answer is South Andaman and Little Andaman. See, Kar Nicobar Andaman ke niche hai pura. Ve Andaman ke niche nahi, Duncan Passage, this is Little Andaman. Ye jo Great Andaman hai, ye Duncan Passage hai. Uske baad yaha 10 degree channel hai. Then the Nicobar group start hota hai. So this can be easily eliminated, this can be easily eliminated. North Andaman, Middle Andaman, South Andaman, aisa hota hai. It is not between North and South. So this is also wrong. Getting me? So D the answer. Very broad questions come in the exam. Match list 1 where beaches are given and list 2 where states are given. This kind of questions, you know, very occasionally comes. We better skip. If you do not know, you better leave them. Hardly they come. Every year they don't come. Like list 1 mein Gopnath Beach. Gopnath Beach is important beach of Gujarat. If you know well and good. Otherwise at least identify Sinkaram Beach. Because Sinkaram is what? Goa Beach. Log jaate hai na Goa. Like Gopnath is in Gujarat. So if you know one or two you can find. At least two if you know you can work out. If you only know one, maybe one or two options can be eliminated. Then you decide whether to take risk or not. So Gopnath, Gujarat, A will go with 3. If you know this, A and C can be eliminated. Then Larsen's Bay is in Visakhapatnam. It is in Andhra Pradesh. If you know, you will get the answer. Or at least if you know Sinkaram is in Goa, that means D will go with 4. Then you can eliminate this, you can eliminate this. Then B and C will be left. You have to work out. Somehow you can manage, right? Otherwise, Devbagh is in Karnataka. Similarly, Larsen's Bay is in Andhra Pradesh, you know that. So, hope you understand. B the answer. Question from 2017. At one of the places in India, if you stand on the seashore and watch the sea, you will find that the sea water recedes from the shoreline a few kilometers and come back to the shore twice a day. And you can actually walk on the seafloor when the water recedes. This unique phenomenon is seen at. So, it is at Chandipur, Odisha. That's why people go to Chandipur. C the answer. Suppose if the question is not on islands also, then you may expect a question from northern plains and on desert. Generally question is say aayega nahi, but still we will see. This is not very important point for IAS. Just for safe side I am telling you, northern plains. They extend for a distance of about 3200 km and width of this plain varies from 150 km to 300 km. No need to remember. Majority of these plains consist of alluvial soils. We soils ki topic mein baat karenge. Just a point mind mein rakhe choti exams ke liye. If you see the regions, the Punjab wala side is Babar region. That is just below the Shivaliks. After that, Terai region, mostly in Nepal and the northern UP. Terai region. And Assam, Brahmaputra area mein, that is Duars. So Babar, Terai, Duar. What are these? Aisa puch sakta hai. Ya arrange them from west to east. Aisa puch sakta hai. Chote exams mein. Babar, Terai, Duar. So similarly, old alluvial and new alluvial. Old alluvial are known as Bangar. And new alluvial is known as Kadar. Generally, Kadar means new alluvial. Like if there is a river, just adjoining that river, you know, every year new sediments will come. That is new alluvial soils. That is Kadar. So that has more fine particles and is more fertile than Bangar. Bangar is like little far from the rivers. So old alluvials. Just names mind where, okay, nothing to take. Similarly, Thar Desert. Thar Desert or Great Indian Desert is world's 9th largest desert. It extends from western margins of Aravali Hills. Luni is the only prominent river you find here. And in Pakistan also, this desert continues as Cholistan desert. So So third digit covers 61% of geographic area of Rajasthan. Hope you understand some facts. Don't waste a lot of your time here. Suppose if the question is not here, there could be a chance that the question could be on political map. Even there are frequent questions on this, but not from here. This is important, most important, then this one, then third, then fourth. But I put it before because to give you an order. So now we'll see political map. Here two things you need to understand, the states and its boundaries and important cities. Suppose if you talk, at least few states you need to understand with how many other states they share boundaries. Telangana, because which is newly formed, at least you remember, if you see for all, if you know the map, well and good, otherwise Telangana is surrounded by four states, not five. Like they are Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh, not Odisha, because a beach may, actually these villages, jo Telangana ka hai, but they were taken by Andhra Pradesh. Like 14 mandals are added to Andhra Pradesh because of Polavaram project. We don't go deep into that, but you understand Telangana is surrounded by four states. Andhra, Karnataka, Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh. Similarly, if you know for all states well and good, at least you focus on these states. South mein sabse jyada states ke saath boundary share karta hai Karnataka. Karnataka shares boundary with Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra and Goa. You can imagine. So six states ke through it shares border. So Karnataka is surrounded by six states. Hope you understand this. Because Telangana separate hone ke baad pehle 5 states tha. Now 6 ho gaya. Because Telangana, Andhra 2 ho gaya. Similarly you see Maharashtra, it is also surrounded by 6 states. Goa, Karnataka, Telangana, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. Hope you understand. Maharashtra is also surrounded by 6 states. So remember Karnataka 6, Maharashtra 6. Don't just mug up. Imagine the picture. Then we talk about Chhattisgarh, which is very important because it extends like this. So it is surrounded by many states. So Chhattisgarh is surrounded by Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, even Uttar Pradesh. Jharkhand, Bihar nahi hai. Uttar Pradesh aa jata hai beech mein. Uttar Pradesh and Jharkhand. So Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Odisha. So it is surrounded by 7 states. Chhattisgarh, ye puchta rehta hai. Chhattisgarh is surrounded by 7 states. Hope you understand. Similarly, Assam is important. Assam is also surrounded by 7 states. All North Indian states like Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, Meghalaya. So all other Northeastern Indian states are surrounded by Assam, even West Bengal. Hope you understand. And Assam shares border with Bangladesh also, Bhutan also. So 2 countries and 7 states. Assam mind mein rakhe. Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh center mein hai, lekin it badi states hai iska surrounding mein. That's why it is surrounded by only 5 states. Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand nahi aata hai, pura UP cover kar deta hai yaha. Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Rajasthan. Madhya Pradesh ka 5 states. Then Uttar Pradesh is important and it is surrounded by maximum number of states, that is 8 states. Uttar Pradesh, if you see Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh also. But Punjab is not there. Please note, Punjab aur Uttar Pradesh ke beech mein Haryana aa jata hai. Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand. Hope you understand. So Uttar Pradesh is surrounded by 8 states. That is the maximum, highest for any state of India. Now we understand some important regions. Kahi matching mein fayda hoga. So Bastar region, Chhattisgarh mein. We have Rayalaseema, Andhra Pradesh mein. Vidarbha region, Maharashtra. Betul, Madhya Pradesh. Kutch region, Gujarat. Malwa region, Maharashtra. Bundelkhand, MP and UP. Chota Nagpur, Jharkhand. Take these questions asked in 2007. Out of the four southern states, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, which shares the boundaries with the maximum number of Indian states? Kerala to sirf Tamil Nadu, Karnataka ke saath share karega. Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Karnataka, Kerala. So Andhra Pradesh, pehle jo 2007 mein pooja tha, tab different answer hoga because Andhra Pradesh was not separated. Now it is separated. Andhra Pradesh share Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Five only. Whereas Karnataka share six. So south mein Karnataka jyada ho gaya abhi. So Karnataka only the answer now. But jab ye question pucha tha tab to each of Andhra and Karnataka. Because tab Karnataka bhi panch tha. So tab C answer tha. Now B answer hai. Which one of the following states border Uttar Pradesh? Uttar Pradesh ke saath Rajasthan border karta hai, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand sab karta hai. Punjab nahi karta hai. Punjab aur Uttar Pradesh ke beech mein Haryana aa jata hai. So Punjab does not border. So one is wrong. Even if you know that one is wrong, you can eliminate all options. Not exactly hum work out karenge aisa questions pe. You need broad idea. So B the answer. Don't waste lot of your time in remembering each state. Just roughly ek bar mind mein map ko rakhe, uske baad jo hoga hoga. Hope you understand this. Thank you for watching this.